हेलो क्लास, वेलकम टू अर्जुन इंग्लिश स्कूल। इन स्टेटिस्टिक्स टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5। दिस इज द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर स्टेटिस्टिक्स सब्जेक्ट। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज डिफरेंशिएशन। दिस चैप्टर इज हैविंग अ वेटेज ऑफ 10 मार्क्स एंड इट इज क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट चैप्टर। सो प्लीज कॉन्सेंट्रेट फॉर फुल चैप्टर्स। देयर आर अराउंड 10 टू 11 रूल्स। And now we are going to start the meaning of differentiation and then after some basic part of this chapter. Okay? So first of all, meaning of differentiation means what is differentiation? A method of studying the rate of changes in dependent variable. So now here focus on changes in dependent variable. We can say anything like that is dependent variable, like more you study, more you will get full result. More you are using mobile phone, less you have got the marks. It means these two variables are dependent on each other. So if change in dependent variable means what? If you have not studied in entire 12th standard, but right now for 2 to 3 months you change your schedule and you are focusing on your study, means changes in dependent variable. With respect to small changes in the value of independent variable, means changes in dependent variable with respect to small changes in independent variable. So this is called differentiation. Okay? And we can call it as like derivatives. In science stream as well as in your commerce stream for colleges, this chapter is most important that you have to study again in colleges. Okay? So now focus on the chapter. The meaning is changes in dependent variable with respect to small changes in the value of independent variable, that is called differentiation. Now here there are some functions where one value is given and if they ask to find out first derivative, or like we can say that they ask for second derivatives. So now if our normal function is y, if our normal function is y and if I want to use derivatives, then first derivative is that we call dy upon dx. Got it? This is the y and derivative that we call d upon dx. D upon dx stands for derivatives. So d upon dx and it multiplied with y, so it becomes dy upon dx. And again, if we want to find out the second derivatives, then square of d and square of x. So now it becomes d square y upon dx square. Got it? So here y is the original function for which we have applied the techniques of derivatives, and here it is the first derivative and here it's a second derivative. Now if there is a function that is called f of x, then now if it is y then dy upon dx, but it is f of x, we cannot say that like d into f of x upon d of x. No, that is wrong. If the function is f of x, then first derivative that is called f dash x and second derivative is f double dash x. Understood? So these two types of derivatives that are frequently in the question, and here there is one example. Yes, this is one another formula. Y is equals to x raised to n. Y is the original function and we want to apply derivative on x raised to n. So now, as you all know, the it is a main object. So if here x raised to n, then here power is m, so n is multiplied with x, like n into x. Understood? Here x raised to n, but x is the main object, and anything in the power of x, it comes into the multiplication with n into x raised to. Here it is n. So now n minus 1, which reduce 1 from this power. Here there is one example where you can see that y is equals to 50x square. Now, if we are applying derivatives, then it becomes dy upon dx, and here power is 2 and base is x. So now if I am applying this kind of formula, then n and x are in multiplication. So here n is 2, 50 remains as it is, and it multiplied with x raised to n minus 1. Here the power is 2, so 2 minus 1, once again 2 is the power of base x. So if 2 multiplied, 2 goes into the multiplied with the base x, so 2 into x, and here 50 remains as it is. But here the power is 2, so deduct 1 as per the formula. So now 2 into 50, it becomes 100 into x, here 2 minus 1, so x raised to 1, or we can say that into x. Understood? So here when we are applying this formula, only when x raised to n, which x is the main objective and having a power like any number. If here it is 2, then it becomes 1. Because as per formula, we have to reduce 1. Okay, first completed, second completed, third completed, as well as sixth completed. Now, here, y is 250, y is equals to 50. But you can see that here in this question, there is no x at all. And here the main importance is for x. And value of x is equals to 1. But here there is no x, so it becomes 0. Understood? Here if it is 50, then it becomes 0. But if it is 50x, if it is 50x, then instead of x, we can write 1, because x is the main objective and the value of x is equals to 1 in derivatives, and that's why here instead of x we write 1. So 50 into 1 becomes 50. This is already completed. Now y is equals to 10. Next, the number of 7 digits. But here again there is no x, and in derivative the main objective is x, so if there is no x, it becomes 0. But yes, if there is x, then it will become as it is. So in derivative there is no value for 10 leg. Yes, but there is value of 2x, because instead of x our answer is 1. So 2 ones are 2. Means if it is, if the value is 10 leg, but there is no value for 10 leg. But if there is x, yes, there is a value, that is 2. Means here 10 leg becomes 0, but 2x becomes 2. Here I want to differentiate between these two, that the importance of x. But yes, if there is any power in base x, then power comes into the multiplication with base, and from power reduce 1. So these are different 7 examples that I have noted for better understanding, because in this chapter we are not trying to explain this simple way. There are large sums, and we have to apply different techniques to solve these derivatives. Now there are 11 rules in this chapter, out of which 2 2 to 3 rules that are removed from their syllabus in specific for this year. Like here there is rule 1, derivative by using definition. Here the method used, definition method, yes, we have to do a derivative, but the method is definition method. So here, if you want to apply derivative, if you want to do a derivative but by applying definition method, then formula is f dash x. F dash x means derivative of f of x. So f dash x is equals to limit h tends to 0, where f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So this is the formula. There are exercise 5.1 based on this definition method. But yes, this method is removed from your syllabus specific for this year. So we are not discussing anymore regarding this method, that is rule number 1. This rule is called method of definition. How we can identify that this is the method? In the question, they specifically ask for finding derivatives by using the definition method. So if they ask for definition method, it means you have to understand that this is not in our syllabus specific for this year. Now, rule number 2, that is rule of addition and subtraction. Here is a simple rule and simple derivatives. Yes, it is in syllabus and having a weightage of 1 to 2 marks for this rule, because there are majority, there are no practical sums for this rule, but they can ask for this formula. So how we can identify that this is the rule applicable here? So where between two variables, if the sign is for positive or negative, is plus or minus, then we have to apply this rule, where you can see that y is equals to u plus or minus v, where y is the main function, and we have to apply the derivative. It becomes dy upon dx. Understood? So what is the derivative for this? So here it may be the sign positive or negative, so it remains as it is. If it is plus, then apply plus here. If there is minus, then apply minus here. Now, derivative of u. So this is for derivative d upon dx, and derivative of u, so it becomes du upon dx. And again, derivative of v. So v is as it is, and d upon dx that we added, so it becomes dv upon dx. So finally, the main function y is equal to u plus or minus v, and derivative of y dy upon dx is equal to du upon dx plus or minus dv upon dx. So this is the rule 2, and here we have completed 2 rules. Now remaining rules are in the next class. Okay?